I've been playing with the new QwQ reasoning model, and I must say, it's actually really impressive. There are plenty of videos out there that can explain the technical details around this model way better than I can, but what piqued my interest were the benchmarks provided on this page. Apparently, this model, which is only a 32 billion parameter model, is outperforming the DeepSeek R1 model, and not the distilled models, by the way, but the original DeepSeek R1 model in certain benchmarks. And you can see this graph over here. So whether or not you tend to believe these benchmarks, what you can't argue is the difference in file sizes between these models. If I go to a Llama, and let's actually have a look at the QwQ model, and here you will see this model only weighs in at about 20 gig, whereas the DeepSeek R1 model, this actually changes from 7 billion parameter to the original 671 billion parameter model. And yes, this is the model that QwQ is comparing themselves against. And you can see between these blue and red columns how close these models are in performance. Yet, QwQ is only 20 gig versus DeepSeek R1's 404 gigabytes. Now, from an application development point of view, there's another factor that you have to consider. When I created an n8n video on using DeepSeek R1, you guys pointed out that this model doesn't have tool calling capabilities, which could be a limiting factor in some of our workflows. But I've got good news. QwQ does support tool calling. This means when we're building applications using this model, we are indeed able to assign tools to this model. This means we can build agentic workflows that use the QwQ model, whether you're running it locally or in the cloud, and you can assign things like memory and tools to this agent as well, which was not possible with DeepSeek R1. So in this video, I will show you how you can download and use QwQ locally on your own machine. If you don't have the hardware to do so, I will also show you how you can use this model for free using Groq Cloud. First things first, in n8n, let's create a new workflow and let's assign an on-chat message trigger, and let's also go ahead and assign our AI agent node. I'm also going to rename this to QwQ Demo. Now, for the chat model, we can run this model locally, or we can run it in the cloud using something like Groq or OpenRouter or the official QwQ service. Let's have a look at running this locally first. To download and run this model on your own machine, go to olama.com and download and install Olama for your operating system. A card will pop up right now where you can view the full Olama tutorial on my channel. After downloading and installing Olama, simply go to Models, go to QwQ, then copy this command, and in your terminal or command prompt, simply paste in that command and press Enter. This will now download and run QwQ. If it was your first time running this command, it will download QwQ, which, as a reminder, is about 20 gigs big, and you can then send a message to this model. And because this is a reasoning model, it will first show you the thinking process, and then it will send you the final response. I'm simply going to exit out of the terminal, and we can now close this command prompt window. Let's click on chat model, then let's go to Olama, and initially you have to create new credentials, then change this from localhost to 127 to 0.0.1 and click on save, and now the setup was completed. In the list of models, simply select QwQ and that should be it. I'm just going to rename this model to QwQ Local and let's test this workflow. So they simply say something very, very simple. And I must tell you, my laptop is really screaming at me at the moment. I've got an RTX 4070 GPU in my laptop, and this model is really pushing the limits of what is possible here, especially while I'm running recording software as well. And here we go. We can see the reasoning steps as well as the final response. Right, now running this on your own machine can be extremely difficult and resource intensive. Trust me. So the alternative is to use a cloud service, something like OpenRouter, which also supports QwQ, but do take note this is not free. And alternatively, you can try to use their official platform. So if I go to blog and let's scroll all the way down to this page where they talk about the API key. So this section says you can get the API key from this page over here. But when I open this page, everything seems to be in Chinese. And I try translating this to English, but honestly, I couldn't navigate this page and I really struggled with it. So the best solution I found for running this model for free is to use a popular service called Groq. Simply go to groq.com, then click on Dev Console, and then sign up for an account. This is totally free. And after you've signed in, you can test out many open source models, including QwQ32B. What we want to do though is get an API key from this API keys page. So click on create API key. Let's give it a name like YouTube tutorial, copy the key, and then back in n8n, I'm going to just break this connection. Let's add a new chat model. Let's open up Groq. Then under credentials, click on create new credential. I'll just call this YouTube tutorial. And let's add that API key. Let's save this. If everything was done successfully, you'll have this green connection. And now in the list of models, you can see all the models that were available in the playground as well. But what we're interested in is QwQ32B. I'm going to rename this node to QwQ Cloud. Then let's test this again in the chat. So let's ask something like hello again. And this time we received the response in less than 2 seconds. Let's try something that's a bit more complicated though. Let's say plan a holiday trip to Cape Town for 2 people and for 2 days with a $1,000 budget. Let's send this. And you will notice that Groq is blazingly fast. We can see the model is still running. And now we get this response. So it's showing the reasoning steps. And if we scroll down, you'll notice how long this reply actually is, how detailed this is. And if we scroll down all the way to the bottom, we can see the full plan over here for day 1 and for day 2, with the budget breakdowns, cost saving tips, etc. Now, so far, this is something that DeepSeek R1 could have done as well, right? But what makes QwQ impressive is that it does support tool use as well. So what we could do is add something like a Gmail tool to send an email. I'll just let the assistant decide on the to email, the subject, as well as the message. Great, so going back to the canvas, let's restart this chat. And let's say, write a thesis on how we might design artificial photosynthesis systems that improve upon natural photosynthesis, efficiency, while being economically viable. Also, email this thesis to leonfonseldev@gmail.com, include proper HTML styling. Let's send this, and looking at our workflow, we can see that the email tool was called, and in the response, it's saying that the email was sent, and going back to my emails, I received the email along with this thesis from the model. Let me know what you think. Is this a true competitor to DeepSeek R1? Or is this another model that's completely overhyped? Also, check out my full n8n AI agents tutorial to learn everything there is to know about building agentic systems in n8n. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.